Hey guys, what's up? So today in this video I'm going to talk about interface static method with respect to overriding. In the previous video I have spoken about how to create the static method in interface, how to call the static method of interface, and what is the purpose of using static methods in interfaces. Okay, so let's start. So basically I'll be discussing three cases and interface static method with respect to overriding, right? So I'll be moving to Eclipse IDE, and then let's discuss the first case. So in the first case I'll be discussing that defining the exactly same static method in the child class. Okay, so this is the interface, and in that I'll create one static method. Let's say public static, and the name of the method is static method. And let's print static method. Okay, so this static method we have created, and then let's create a implementation class. Okay, so in the case one we will be having a same static method, right? So I'll just do copy paste. And now you can see that there is no error, right? Same method I have copied in the child class, then also there is no error, right? So although methods are same, this is not the overriding, because static methods of interfaces are not available to the child class. Already we have discussed in the previous video that the interface are by default not available to the child class, and if we want to call the static method of the interface, we can only call using only one way, right? We can only call using static method demo or interface name only we can call the static method of the interface. So this specific implementation is for the main. So this is the static method for the child class. It is child specific method, and this is parent specific method. Okay, so there is no relationship between this method in the interface and this method, right? So they are totally different. Okay, so we can give some different print statement here. My own implementation. Okay guys, so static methods, for static methods overriding concept is not applicable, because static methods are only and only can be called interface name. Okay, so let's start with the case 2. So in the case 2, what I will do is I'll comment it out first, and then so this was the case 1, and in the case 2 I will change the method. I'll change the modifier from static to non-static, so this will be non-static. So you can see that there is no error, right? So in the normal class, if we are changing from static to non-static, right, if suppose there is a method which is static in the normal class, and in the subclass if we are trying to change the modifier from static to non-static, we'll get compile time error, right? So but in this case, as we know that static methods are only and only can be called using the interface name, and these static methods are not available to the child class, right? So that's why there is no compile time error here. Okay, so even if we are changing from static to static, there is no error, and this is not the overriding. Okay guys, so let's start with case 3. So in case 3, what I will do is I will change the access modifier from public to private. Okay, so let me change from public to private. Okay, so you can see that there is no compile time error here, because in case of method overriding, there is a concept that if we are changing from public to private, right, if we are restricting the access modifier in the child class, we should get compile time error here, right? But in this case, this is the different method. This is totally different method, and it is only and only for the parent interface. So this static method is of static method demo. This method is of subclass, so there is no overriding concept here. Okay, right. So this is all about three cases in the interfaces of static methods. Okay, guys. So static methods in interfaces, there is no concept of overriding. Overriding is not applicable for the static methods in interfaces, right, guys? So this is all about overriding with respect to interfaces of static methods. So thank you, guys. Thank you for watching this video, and please subscribe the channel to get further updates on Java, Selenium, as well as Appian. Thank you.